This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to show how to solve some trigonometric problems by using Pythagorean identities. So here's the first problem. This says, find the sine of theta if the cosine of theta equals negative square root of 3 over 2, and theta terminates in quadrant 3. Okay, so we're looking for a sine, and we're given a cosine. And we've got a trigonometric identity that equates sines and cosines. This says the sine squared of theta plus the cosine squared of theta equals 1. So if we're looking for the sine of theta, let's get the sine squared by itself. We'll have sine squared of theta equals 1 minus the cosine squared of theta. And let's plug in the value for cosine of theta. That was negative square root of 3 over 2. Negative square root of 3 over 2. We want to square that. So we're going to have 1 minus, let's see, negative square root of 3 squared is going to be 3. And 2 squared is 4. So that's 1 minus 3 fourths. That equals 1 over 4. And that's the sine squared of theta. We want the sine of theta. So we'll take the square root of both sides. The square root of 1 quarter is 1 half. Now, sines are sometimes positive and sometimes negative. That depends on what quadrant the angle terminates in. And in this case, it terminates in quadrant 3. So we're going to have an angle that begins in standard position, terminates in quadrant 3. In quadrant 3, sines are negative because the y values are negative. So this sine of theta is going to equal negative 1 half. Okay? So pay attention to the quadrant that your angle terminates in. That will tell you whether your function ends up being positive or negative. Okay, let's try another one. Let's do one with tangents and secants. So we're going to have find the tangent of theta if the secant of theta equals, let's see, negative 2 times the square root of 3 over 3, and we'll have this terminate in quadrant 2. So the Pythagorean identity we want is going to be the one that says the tangent squared of theta plus 1 equals the secant squared of theta. Okay, we're looking for a tangent. So let's isolate tangent squared on one side of the equation, and we'll have that equals secant squared of theta minus 1. And secant of theta was negative 2 times the square root of 3 over 3. So we want negative 2 times the square root of 3 over 3 squared minus 1. Well, negative 2 squared is 4. Square root of 3 squared is 3. So 4 times 3 is 12. And 3 squared is 9. So I've got 12 over 9 minus 1. Let's take that 1 and turn it into 9 over 9. So 12 ninths minus 9 ninths is just 3 over 9. And that's the tangent squared of theta. So we want to take the square roots of both sides. I'm going to have the tangent of theta equals the square root of 3 over 3. And let's see. Theta terminates in quadrant 2. So over here in quadrant 2, tangents are negative because the y values are positive and the x values are negative. So this tangent of theta is going to be negative square root of 3 over 3. And let's fit in one more. So let's do find the cosecant of theta if the cotangent equals, let's just have that equal 1, and we'll put that in the first quadrant. Okay, so my Pythagorean identity, the one I want to use, the one that has cotangents and cosecants, is 1 plus the cotangent squared of theta, let me fix that theta, of theta equals the cosecant squared of theta. I'm going to swap the sides of this equation, so the cosecant is on the left side. So cosecant squared of theta equals 1 plus cotangent squared of theta. We'll put in the value for the cotangent of theta. Cotangent of theta was just 1. Okay, so that's going to be 1 squared. 1 plus 1 squared is 2. So the cosecant squared of theta is 2, which means that the cosecant of theta will be the square root of 2. Let's see if that's positive or negative. Theta terminates in quadrant 1. So in quadrant 1, all of the trig functions are positive. So we're going to have cosecant of theta equals the square root of 2. Okay, that's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.